हेलो सचिन, यू आर एबल टू सी माई स्क्रीन राइट? फाइन, लेट्स स्टार्ट टिल द टाइम अदर पीपल्स कैन ज्वाइन इन. सो आई होप दैट यस्टरडे यू ऑल वेंट थ्रू whatever concepts were taught yesterday. I hope you don't have any queries or any doubts regarding that, right? Bodies, bapis, enhancements, enhancement point, enhancement section, enhancement options, explicit, implicit, enhancements of standard dictionary, tables and structures, right? No queries, right? Okay. What about you, Elsie? Elsie, Anand, any queries regarding yesterday's topics? Enhancements and bapis and bodies? Hello. Okay, fine. Then we will start with today's topics, web services, which is the last topic. Okay, so basically your web service is a independent modular self-describing application function or service, as you can say, okay, and it is based on XML and other standards, and it can be located or called using the internet protocols. So what I mean is basically your web service has a list of methods and procedures that can be used by any of the programming applications irrespective of any programming languages, operating system, hardware or anything. Any type of applications can access the functionality which is provided by the web service, and such functionality is called web methods or web APIs. So basically a web service allows the communication via internet standards, that is XML and HTTP. So allows the communication via internet standards that is XML and HTTP. So I'll just okay. So web services allows this the communication via internet standards, that is XML and HTTP. So once you deploy a web service on the internet, it can be used by any of the clients using these two standards, that is HTML and XML and HTTP. The service can be readily available to any clients who needs access to it. Okay, so what basically web service is like, whatever service you want to provide out of SAP or whatever service you want to consume in SAP from any SAP system or from non-SAP system, that communication happens via the internet standards, that is XML and HTTP, and accordingly either you can consume a web service or either you can provide a web service. So basically there are, in simple words, web services are used to exchange data between SAP to SAP systems or SAP to non-SAP systems. Okay, in most of the cases it will be SAP to non-SAP systems. So it is used to exchange data between SAP and non-SAP systems. There are two types of web services. One is your web service provider, and other is your consumers. Provider is where you will provide your service, and consumer where you will be consuming the service. Okay? Up to this point, is it clear? The introduction. There are two kinds of web services. One is your web service provider, and the other is your web service consumer. So first we will see how to create a web service provider. Okay. I'll open the system. So, for creating a web service provider, first we create a function module and a function group. Okay. So, just for the intensity to save time, just for the sake of time, I have created a function module. As in, what is the logic that I have written is, I will be passing a material number for the same and getting the material details out of it. Okay. So, the first step is that you need to create a function module and a function group for a web service provider. So, create a function module and a function group. Then, from the next step onwards, I will show you now what we need to do. Okay. Then, from here, click on utilities. Click on more utilities. There is an option called create web service from the function module. Click on this option. So once you click on this option, it will ask you for a service definition name. So provide a service definition name, zweb_demo_srv. Okay. Description is demo web service. So provide a This is your service definition name. Fine. Now click on continue. After that, it will ask you to map this function module name. Okay. Enter the name of the function module. Since I am already creating it from the function module, so automatically the function module name will come. So select map the name, okay, of this function module if you want to map the name, or in case if you don't want, it's fine. Continue. Automatically this SOAP application and this profile will be created. Here you have got different options. There is authentication with certificates and transport guarantee, authentication with user and password, no transport guarantee, authentication with user and password, transport guarantee, no authentication, no transport guarantee. We will select this authentication with user and password, no transport guarantee, because we have user and password for the same. Okay. Now, here provide your package. And provide your TR. So suppose I'll select this, then click on continue. Okay. Once you now see, the last step is choose finish to create the web service, zweb demo SRV, which you have created. Okay. Now click on complete. Now see, this complete service definition got created. Can you see? This complete service definition got created. Click on save. Okay, then click on activate. It will take some time to get activated. Okay, now the web service has been fully activated. Can you see? Now here, see, if you see this page clearly, can you see this referenced object? So basically this web service is referencing this function module of yours. This is the first part. Okay, now if I go back one step, if you go to the external view here, if you see, it has automatically mapped the parameters which were there with the function module. So input parameter was material number, output parameter was material details. So this automatically got mapped from there. Internal view and external view will almost be same. Now going to the types, it will be of the types whatever you have given with respect to your function module. So I've given with respect to Mara, hence it is showing with respect to Mara. See here. Okay. Now other important part is, you can leave this configuration part because we selected whatever configuration, this gets created automatically. Now the other important part is this WSDL. This WSDL is the other important part. Okay, this WSDL is your web service description language. So on completing the step 2, your WSDL will be completely generated, which is your web service definition description language. Okay, so in a web service provider, the service provider have a corresponding XML based description of the web service in your web service description language, which is called the WSDL document. This one is your WSDL document completely. So I'll again repeat, the web service provider will have a corresponding XML based description of the web service in a web service description language. And in principle, any programming language can be used to implement this service based on the HTTP and SOAP protocol. So I'll add one statement here. That service provider will have a corresponding XML based description of the web service in the WSDL. Okay, now once you have got your WSDL, as in, go here, this is your WSDL which has been generated, right? So if I came from here, in case if you want to see how to access the enterprise service provider, go to SE80, click on edit object here, click on enhanced options, you go here, go to your enterprise services and web service definition and the service definition. What is the service definition? This is your service definition which you got created. Enter this and see here, it will open your web service. See here, it will open your web service. Okay. So, how to go again? Go to SCET. I'll show you. Go to SCET. Click on Edit Object. Click on Enhanced Options. Click on Enterprise Services. Click on Web Service Definition. Provide the web service definition which you created in the last few steps. Enter. And this way you will be able to open your web service entire details which you just created now. And this is your WSDL which I was just talking about. So up to this step, is it clear guys? The steps which I showed you. Okay, fine. Now, the next step is to, once you have created the service definition via SCET, from the steps as I showed you just now, we have to create a binding for this service in the SOA manager, because for once you are providing a service, someone has to consume the service, right? And the other team which will be consuming the service, they need this WSDL URL, and along with that they need a binding URL. So we have got a WSDL URL, that is this one, but we need the binding URL also now. Now to generate the binding URL, we need to go to SOA manager. So the T code is /o SOA MANAGER, SOA manager. Once you provide this T code, automatically it will open up a web browser. Just a second. See here, this automatically opened up, okay. But because of some SSO restrictions and all in this system, you will not be able to properly access via SOA manager. But otherwise, the T code that you need to go access is via SOA manager. I'll mention the T code here. So just for your reference, I've given the link which you need to use for opening the SOA manager directly, because the T code will not work because of SSO restrictions and all. Okay. So I've directly given you the link here. Use this link to open the SOA manager. So once you provide this URL, user SCR27 SM1, you provide your user ID and password. Okay. Then once you have entered the SOA manager, this is how the screen will look like. Then go to your web service configuration. Once you go to a web service configuration, pick up your web service definition from here. Okay. Provide the name and click on enter. Provide the service definition name and click on enter. Here automatically the details will come. Okay. Once now the detail comes, then click on create service. So first step, go back. Give the name here, the details will come. Oh, click on this. Once you click on this, click on create service. Okay. Then it will ask you to create a service name. Okay. It will ask you to create, provide the service name. So what I'll do, I'll take the same type of name. So Z Web Demo Service. demo. Okay. Zweb demo underscore bind. So you can, this is the your binding service name. Okay. Then click on next. Once you click on next, see here it will be none HTTP, message level security none, authentication settings none. You don't need to do anything. Just you need to tick on this transport channel authentication, user ID and password. Remember, in the previous steps, I had chosen this option, that is user ID and password. So hence the reason I'll be choosing this option, user ID and password. So once I've chosen this option, click on next. Okay. Then it will ask you, it will show this screen, that is alternative access protocol and all these things. Okay. Here you don't need to do anything. Only thing that you need to do is provide a binding service name, which I just gave like this. So I'll just keep this details for you all. Okay. Now, next, in the next step, just you need to click on user ID and password. Don't forget, click on this user ID and password, then click on next, then click on finish. Once you click on finish, automatically, can you see this? This is your binding service URL which got generated. Zdemo underscore web underscore bind. Zweb demo bind. Can you see this? So this got generated. Now, if you click on this option, okay, open the binding WSDL generation. See here, this is your WSDL URL for binding. This is your WSDL URL for binding. We will copy this because we will need this. So, WSDL URL for okay, so I'll rectify this. So this is my WSDL URL for binding. So I created the web service provider as in the service definition. Then I went to the SOA manager to create the binding URL for the same. I followed the steps, and then after the steps, what we did, we got our WSDL URL for binding. Okay. So now your web service provider is ready. Now the team which wants to consume your service, so you need to provide this WSDL URL which we just copied now. That is the WSDL binding URL, and from here the WSDL URL, these two URL. So this is your WSDL URL. Okay. You need to share the WSDL URL and the WSDL URL. So what you need to do is, we need to share the WSDL and binding URLs with the non-SAP team which wants to consume our service. So share the WSDL URL for binding, and here I'll mention the WSDL URL as well. Excuse me. Okay, so this is my WSDL URL. Fine. this is your binding steps which we just created, and we got the WSDL URL for binding as well. Up to this point, is it clear, guys? So understood the steps till now that we followed to create the web service provider. So from the web service provider, we got the your we got our WSDL URL and the WSDL binding URL, right? So what is the full form of WSDL URL? Who will want to say it? What is the full form of WSDL? Anyone? Yeah, web services description language. One more thing which you need to do is, since I am providing user ID and password, so we will make it in the communication security, in the provider security, here you make sure that you give your user ID and password here. Make sure that you give your user ID and password here. This is important. Okay. This is important. Otherwise, you will get issues because we are the person who will be consuming our web service has to do a handshake with the services that we are providing from our system via your authentication, which is via your user ID and password. That is the reason. Please select this option, that is user ID and password. Okay. Now that we have exposed our web service, we will try to consume this web service in our SAP system. Just think that this URLs, which I just showed now, is not coming from your system. Just think the other way around, just for the time being, okay? Though we are providing these services here, just think that for the time being, these are the services which are provided by some system and we need to consume this service, okay? Just think that we need to consume this service. So, how will we consume this service? And one more thing, this is your service, right? In case, SAT, edit object, enhance options, enterprise services, web service definition, provide your web service definition name. Now, if you want to test this service, okay. Yeah, I've given the URL. Credentials is your credentials. I have mentioned the URL here. You will get this document, Naresh. Got the point? Okay. So, yeah, if you want to test this service, generate request template and on, then click on execute. So, once you click on execute, it will ask you to provide the material number here. What you do is go click on this option, that is XML editor. Okay, provide a material number here. So suppose I provide the material number as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 21. And then click on execute. Can you see the material details came? The entire material details came for this material number, right? So once again, I'll show you. Go back. If you want to test the service that you are providing, as in whether it is behaving properly or not, what you need to do is click on execute, that is click on this test button. Once you click on this test button, it will show you a screen like this, a dialog will come. Make sure it is the radio button is selected on generate request template. Then I need to provide an input parameter because my IAMMATNER was my input parameter, right, for the function module. So click on this XML editor, provide the material number here. So I have to, you know that we have done so far that we need to provide 16 zeros and the material number. So 1, 2, and suppose any material number. So now we got the details here. This is the way you can be sure that whatever data you are providing via the web service, whether your web service is working fine or not. Okay, in this way you can test your web service. Now coming to the web service consumer, now coming to the web service consumer, go to the T code. /SE84, okay. Then once you are in the T code SE84, if you double click on the service definition, it will not show you anything because I haven't created anything as of now. Okay. Sorry, don't go to the T code SE84. Best is go to your package where you want to create any web service consumer. So either you can go to your T code SE80. And in SE80, if you can, under your ZDAP app training, suppose this is, I'll go to the package. Okay. Click on create. Okay. Here, see these options. All the options are there, no? Okay, first tell me one thing. Before we proceed with web service consumer, do you want to practice this web service provider? Hello? Before we proceed with web service consumer, do you want to practice this web service provider? Guys, are you there? I have mentioned the steps here. Now you can just follow this document here. It is just next, 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 next. Do one thing, try with the steps, I'll help you out. Is it fine, Asit? all of you start practicing what I just showed you now. First, create a function module and a function group. So, create any function module. Like I have used create this function module. So, create any function module of yours and a function group. Then, from that option, utilities, more utilities, create web service from the function module. Then click on next, 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 next. Okay. After that, once you have done with that, you need to give your service definition name and all those things which you will be giving. Once you are done with your service definition name and you get your WSDL URL, test the same. Then once you are done with step 1 and step 2, open SOAR Manager to get your binding URL. So in the SOAR Manager, I am providing the link, this link in the chat. Use this. Use this link to create your WSDL binding URL. Is it fine, Asit? I'll do one thing. I'll give you 15 minutes. Start with the steps. In case if you're stuck up, I'll help you to recall the steps. Is it fine with everyone? And then we will go further with the web service consumer. Okay. Fine then, start then. You can use any function module of yours, but just make sure that in the attributes, it should be a RFC enabled function module, first point. And you know that for RFC enabled function module, it has to be passed by value. So if you have any of your RFC enabled function module, use the same to create a web service out of it. If you have any RFC enabled function module, use the same to create a web service out of it. So here I'll add a point that this should be RFC enabled function module. Okay. Fine guys, start with the steps. I'll help you in case you are stuck up. I've given you 15 minutes. Guys, go step by step. In case if you are stuck up in any step, just let me know. Go step by step. Thank you. Guys, anyways, I have unmuted you all. In case if anyone wants to ask anything with regard to any of the steps and all, they can unmute themselves and ask in case if they're stuck up in anything. So Anand, Asit, Naresh, Nehal, Sipani, I hope you all are able to proceed with the steps. So Naresh and Sachin, you people were able to start with the steps? Okay, good. I hope all are able to proceed forward. Any queries? You stuck up in any step? Stuck up in any step, guys? Asit, Sachin, Anand, Naresh, Snehal, Sifani? Guys, how's it going? Are you stuck up in any steps? Guys, are you there? Are you able to hear me? Is it done, guys? Can we proceed with the web service consumer? Guys, can you please respond? Okay, last 2 minutes. Fine, let's proceed now. Guys, please focus here. Then you can again continue once I am done with this web service consumer. So, guys, please focus here. So let's so right click on your package, create. It will, you can see the option is enterprise service. Okay, right click on your package, create an enterprise service. So right click on the package, create, then enterprise service. Okay, and then go for this service consumer option. Okay, then go for this service consumer option. Go for the service consumer option. Then here there are three options: backend enterprise service repository and external WSDL schema. What I told you that we will use the WSDL. See, in the last step here I told you, no, see either WSDL URL and the binding URL. So we will use this WSDL URL to create our web service consumer. So click on continue, click on this URL option, because we will provide the URL. Click on this URL option, then here I need to provide the URL for the same. So my WSDL URL is here. This is my WSDL URL, right? So here one replacement that you need to do is, here instead of this, you need to replace this with 103.44.1.51. So here accordingly I'll make the replacement 103.44.1.51. This, why I am replacing this, because in our system this works on this domain and host and all, which if you don't have admin rights you won't be able to maintain the same. So, and if you have admin rights then it's not an issue. So just to avoid any hassle and all those things, just replace this domain and host with this application server IP. So 103.44.1.51. Okay. So once this is done, click on continue. It will ask for this username and password. See here. Once you provide the credentials, it will go to the next step, where it will ask for your package and request and task. So I'll select this, and you need to give a prefix here. You need to give a prefix here, as in how the name of the service will look like. Okay, so it's a consumer service, ZCO_. Okay, ZCO_. Then click on continue, and then click on complete. So see here, this automatically got created from the service consumer with respect to, see this, ZWeb Demo SRV, right? This was the name which had given, right? ZWeb Demo SRV, the web service definition. That service definition name came here. Okay, then since a class will get created via which you will be able to consume the service, click on save. So till the time it gets saved, I'll mention the steps here. Okay, now click on activate. So once, then here provide the WSDL URL. Here I'll mention one step, replace the host with IP. This is applicable only for our system, okay? This is optional. Only for our system, it will not be applicable for your organization systems and all, because there it will come properly. Please make sure that this is applicable only for SAP Yard system, not for other systems. That's why I wrote, I'll remove this step, I'll not write this, otherwise you'll get confused. So provide the WSDL URL, okay? Once you provide the WSDL URL, then your service consumer will get created. So your service consumer will get created. Along with your service consumer, a class will get created, ABAP. Class will also get created. So if you double click on this, see here, a constructor and this method got created, ZFM material detail, the method of with that same. This will get created automatically, implicitly by its own. You don't need to do anything. And if you see the, sorry, in the methods, if you see the parameters, see this, the importing parameter and the response and all, everything got created. Okay. So now come back. Now, once you have created your web service consumer, you need to create a port so as to consume the same in your ABAP system. You need to create a port so as to consume the same in your ABAP system. So, once the web service consumer is created, we need to create a port to consume the same. Okay, and this port will be created via SOA manager again. Port via SOA manager. Okay, so go to the SOA manager. I'll just refresh it once. Provide your credentials. Go to your web service configuration. Now here, select this ABAP name, this name. Okay, here, now see this name came, ZCO WEMO web service. This is the service consumer. Click on this. Once you click on this, it will ask you to create the logical port, which I just told you. Now we need to create a logical port. Okay, now click on create. Here there will be a lot of options. We need to select this WSDL based configuration because we are creating via WSDL. So for logical port creation, in SOA manager, choose the option as WSDL service based configuration. WSDL service configuration. Once this is done, then you need to provide the logical port name. So you need to provide a logical port name here. So suppose ZDemo _ logical port. So logical port for demo. Okay, click on next. Here, it will ask you these different options. WSDL base and all those things, okay. Via HTTP access, via file, WSDL from upload, via HTTP access and all those things. So, if you give this file option, you need to choose the file. If you give this HTTPS option, you need to give the HTTPS. Here, in this best is, in this WSDL base, select this via HTTP access option. And here, you need to provide your binding URL. So, I'll just take a snapshot of this for you. Select this via HTTP access option. Okay. Select this via HTTPS access option and here you provide the binding URL. And here also replace this till mydomain.com with the IP. Okay, provide your username and password here. Okay, then click on next. Here this automatically will get created like this. You don't need to do anything. So here also replace this part with the IP. This is applicable only for this training system which I am showing. Otherwise, you don't need to do anything. Then click on next. Here it will ask you for your again your ID and password. Here again provide your credentials. Okay. Click on next. This automatically, this URL will come on its own. You don't need to do anything. This will come on its own. This URL will get generated on its own. You don't need to do anything. Just replace this part. Okay. Click on next. Okay. Click on next. Okay. Click on next. Done. Click on finish. So once it's done, once you have done this, click on ping this service. Once you ping this service, you should get that web service has been successfully pinged for this. So once again, I'll reiterate the steps here. So for logical port creation, you will go to Swarm Manager, choose this WSDL service configuration, here via HTTP access, here you will provide the binding URL. Provide the binding URL in the above step along with your credentials in case if we are choosing via HTTP access. Okay, then go to the next step. In the binding section in the consumer security, here automatically you have to provide your credentials. Then again a URL will get generated here. See, I'll just again open this. This transport settings, this URL will get generated automatically. So in the transport settings, this URL will get generated automatically. So URL will get generated automatically under transport settings. Fine. Once this is done, you should be able to ping your web service successfully. Once all steps are done, pinging of the web service should be successful. So up to this point, is it clear, guys? Any doubts up to this point? Anyone? Asit, Naresh, Snehal, Shifani, Sachin, any doubts up to this point? Okay, great. Now, once you are done with the creation of the service consumer, then you are done with the creation of the logical port of the same. Now we will consume the web service via your ABAP report or wherever you want to consume this as for your getting your data. Okay, so I'll show you via report. So Z demo report web consume. Okay, create demo report to consume web service. Fine. Executable program. Click on save. Provide this. Provide a TR for image. Then go to the next step. Fine. So what will be the first step here is open that web service consumer and use the ABAP object name which I used here. So what is the ABAP object name which I used? This one, right? So this is your class name, right? So data hello underscore proxy type reference to your class name. So just save, double click on this, it should go to this class. Or you can use the new syntax as in equals to new open braces, close braces. Okay. Now, I'll create a input and a output of the same. Similarly, like this, as in what I mean is signature. Let me take this class name and open it in. So take this class name, go to the parameters of this same. So can you see this input and the output? This is the input to this class method and this is the output. So similarly here also, what I'll do is data input, okay, type, take this and output type as in the response, take this, okay, fine. Now we will use the statement create object lo underscore proxy, okay, exporting the logical port name equals to whatever port name we gave there. So what was the port name we gave there? Zdemo underscore LP. So this will be the port name. So make a note of the port name here. Zdemo underscore LP. Now, one point, since you are using this create object, this syntax here, because we want to create the object with respect to this port name, so you cannot use this syntax here. That is the reason we have to use again in case if you are instantiating an object of a class, automatically that instanced object gets created. But here, since we have to create the instance of a class by passing this logical port name, that's why we cannot create with the help of the new operator like that. That's why I created a reference to this class and create object lo underscore proxy exporting this logical port name. If you do not have to pass the logical port name to create the object, then you can directly use the new operator to create an instance of that class. So once you have done this, now what we will do is we will use this lo underscore proxy, okay, and use the method to get the details. Okay, so what method is there? Let's again go back. Method is ZFM material detail, right? So ZFM material detail. In this, select this and shift and enter. Now, I'll remove this one exception. So here, I'll uncomment this. So in this input, what I'll do is I have to pass the input and the output, we have to get the output. Okay, so in the input, IM underscore matner, we will pass a material number. So suppose I pass the material number here 00234567891. Okay, and I'll pass it here as input. Now in the output, we will get the output here. Okay, after this, just for display purpose, write output Mara, and here suppose MAT KL. Okay, shift and F1, control and F3. Now let me put the debugger. Okay, or I'll put a debugger here. Let me execute this. Sorry, I should have put the debugger here. Okay, now here, see, this lo underscore proxy got created as an object with reference to this class by passing this port name. Why I pass this port name? Because this web service which we will be using, the web service consumer, we defined a logical port for the same here, right? We defined a logical port for the same. So by passing this logical port name, we'll be creating an object reference with respect to this class so that we get details with respect to the web service that we want to consume. Okay. After that, whatever input parameters that we need to pass. So we knew that that web service which we are consuming, as in the web service provider which we created at the initially, that we pass a material number when we get the material details, right? That's why in input im_matner I pass the material number. After that, like object class reference method, how we have learned, in that I am calling this method to get the details of the importing parameter. So if you double click on this output and if you see this Mara, all these material details automatically came. So from here, just for output purpose, I selected this parameter METKL just for output, and once I click on output, here is your output. Up to this point, is it clear, guys? How I consumed the same? I first created an object reference by passing this logical port name. Then I made the create of this input. This can be made dynamic just for demo purpose. I'm showing by passing a material number here. And then I'm using this object and this method to get the output values, and I'm displaying the same. Up to this point, any queries? Up to this point, anyone has got any queries? Clear, Asit, Sachin, Anand, Snehal, Shifani. So I'll just keep this here for your reference. Consume the same via ABAP. So now for just demo purpose, I've shown in a report. This you can use either in a function module or any kind of ABAP repository objects. Okay. So this just for your demo purpose, I showed it in a report. You can use the same in any format you want. Either in a function module, either in a class, either in include, anywhere you want to use it, you can use the same. So in this way, you will be able to consume the web service. So we saw end to end of, like we first saw how to provide a web service. First step, create a RFC based function module, then create a web service out of it, get the service definition name, then go to SOA manager, get the binding URL, share this WSDL URL and the binding URL with the non-SAP team. Yes, 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 Sachin. That's how, no, web from your web service, how do you create a purchase order or a sales order or anything? External system will use your web service. Okay. Suppose you want to get some data into your service. So from your other system, so you will get the data, then you can save the data into your system if you want. Or if you want the other team to post some data into your system, you have to provide a service. So SAP has got some standard web services as well, which the other team uses to create a purchase order, create a goods receipt and all those things. I'm just telling from the demo point of view. Got the point, Sachin? If you want to post any kind of transaction data which other users want to use, you have to provide the standard web services or you have to create your own web service. In case if you want to use other services, as in from the other team, for pushing data or for getting some data from them, then you have to use their service. Got the difference? Sachin, is it clear now? Okay. So one more thing which I just want to show you is that how do you do a web service trace and all in case if you get any errors and all. So there is a cheat code called SRT_UTIL. So here in SRT_UTIL, what you will do is click on this add user. Okay. username, fine, the user has been added. Click on this functional trace, so once you add this user, this is for my ID, right? Performance trace, make it active. Functional trace, make it high. Okay, so performance trace should be, you can make it inactive or active, or I choose to make it active. Functional trace should be high. Okay, once this is done, save the configuration. SRT underscore util, go to the users, add the user. I've added my user ID. Performance trace, make it active. Functional trace, make it high. Okay, then click on the save configuration button so as to your changes can be persisted. Okay, now what you do, go to this report, execute this report. Okay, you got this. Now you go here, click on this functional trace. I'll save this again. I'll once again run this. Okay. See here, can you see the payload trace? We just called this web service now. Can you see this payload trace? So here it will show you the service which just got created. See. You can see, right? Sorry, not under functional trace, check under payload trace. Can you see? Here the service got created. We got called the service. If we go back, execute it once again, go back, check here, refresh it. Can you see? I have called it two times. So it will show you the traces, this payload trace which got created. Double click on the same. It will show you all this, the request and response, whatever you are getting. See here. All this request and response, whatever you are sending, you will be able to see everything. In this way, you can trace your web service, whether it is getting called successfully or is there any error coming while calling the service. So SRT underscore util will help you to trace the service. SRT underscore util. So SRT underscore util will help you to trace the web service and also to get the logs. This utility is very handy when you want to do the analysis if there is any web service doing any issues and all, and you want to see whether that web service call is happening properly or not. This will become very handy, SRT underscore util. So first step will be to add the, where did it go? First step will be to add the user, right click and add the user, double click on your user, performance trace is active, functional trace is high, payload trace is active. Then you run the service, make sure you have selected on both consumer and provider because you can check for anything. Then once you run the service, check for the payload trace, double click on the same. Here you will get all your traces, this 1, 2, 3, 4, can you see this remote function call, everything, whatever is the trace, you will get everything here. And if you want to see the value which got passed, see here. This is your XML, this is your call, this is the entire data which came, everything you will be able to see here. Guys, is it clear now how to trace a web service? Is it clear? There is one more T-code called SRT underscore e-log. This will give errors in case if you get any error while calling any of the web service. SRT underscore e-log will give you the error log for the web services. So, SRT underscore e-log will provide you the error with respect to web services. In case while calling any of the web service, if you get any error, you will be able to see the same under SRT underscore e-log. What's the point, guys? So this is what I had to tell you about web services. So we understood what is a web service. There are two kinds of web services. One is the provider, one is the consumer. For the provider, first step, create a function module, function group, create a web service out of it, provide a web service definition, get the bind web service WSGL description language URL, then go to SWAM manager to get the binding URL. Once you get the binding URL, you need to share both the WSGL and the binding URLs with the non-SAP team, which will consume your service. Contrast to that, if you want to consume any web service, right-click on the package, create enterprise service, service consumer, provide the WSGL URL which the team has shared. Then service consumer will get created and the ABAP class will also get created. Then go to SWAM manager to create your logical port. Create your logical port by providing the WSGL binding URL. Binding URL here, okay. Then automatically URL will get generated under the transport settings. Once everything is done, you should make sure that pinging of the web service should be successful. Okay. Then consuming the same, one step is you need to create a proxy of your class by exporting the logical port name, by using that object instance variable, and by calling the method, you will pass your input and you will get the output. And then you can utilize your output as you want to use. And SRT underscore util and SRT underscore elog are the two utility tools. SRT underscore util will help you to trace the web service and also to get all the logs. And SRT underscore elog will help you with respect to getting the error with respect to your web services. With that, we come to an end to the web services. And with that, we come to an end of this almost six week long training. So guys, any query with respect to the web services? Guys, anyone, any queries? I hope you have got all the steps clearly. And once you practice, maybe today after this training, you will be able to get a fair idea of like how we proceeded with all the steps with respect to creation, to providing the web service, to the consumption of the web service, right? Not an issue, Asit. You practice on the same. In case of any queries, ping on the group with respect to this web service. Fine. Is it fine for you? But at least I hope that you have understood the concepts which I taught you with respect to the steps and with respect to the web service product provider and web service consumption. Asit? And also a very important communication. So one practical example of a web service is simple. See, suppose if you have a .NET team, okay, which wants to create a purchase order from their system, but they want to post entries to your system. So you will provide the standard purchase order web service to them, as in the WSGL URL and the binding URL. They will use your service to create a purchase order in your system and get the purchase order number back. This is a very real-time practical example of a web service. Second one, suppose a Java team has created a document management services application. You want to use their service to post all your PDF copies of your invoices into their system. Okay. You will consume their service and post all the invoices and get the response back. So two very practical and simple examples with respect to one web service provider and one consumer. Is it fine, Asit? So on this note, I'll be signing off with you all. This is Kabir. And I hope that we will again catch up in the future trainings. One very important communication is that from January we will be starting with multiple trainings. We'll be starting with the second batch on the modern MAP training. We'll be covering a lot of new syntaxes along with CDS Advanced and the AMDP courses. Along with that, we'll also be planning one OOPS training along with REST API consumption. So that, because many of you are getting stuck up with these OOPS concepts. So OOPS concepts, along with that, we'll be having our multiple trainings on your like Fiery, UI5 and all this. So just get subscribed to SIPYAD in case if you have not done so, so that you can get communication on the latest updates and the latest trainings that will be coming up. Also expect you to all to be a part of this modern ABAP training which will be coming up in Jan, so that you can explore on the same further. It was great to have a wonderful journey with you for these last 6 weeks. Hope to again catch you up in the coming new year. So for the system, you just need to check in the group. I'm not so sure, but maybe I think till the end of this month at least. Okay, till the end of at least this month, till 30th of November. But in case if you want to have any extension or anything, you can just drop a mail to SAP Yard. Is it fine, Asit? So I hope you had a good learning experience. We'll again catch up next time. On that note, we'll be signing off. Do give your feedback. The link will be provided in the WhatsApp group. Okay? Stay safe, take care. Have a good journey in your career. Wish you all the best. Bye-bye, guys.